Hey everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguy. Do you like nostalgia? Do you like stuff from the 80s, the 90s, the 2000s, and the 2010s? Well, if you do, I have a show for you. And that show is Back in the Day. And Back in the Day, I take you on journeys of nostalgia, such as classic commercials, classic VHS tapes, video games, and much more. So check out Back in the Day every Friday on the Timmy Flyersguy YouTube channel. Everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguy, and welcome to this week's edition of the Timmy Flyersguy Podcast. I'm your host, Timmy Flyersguy, and I got a lot to talk about here in this episode of the Timmy Flyersguy Podcast. I'm going to be talking about my exit from the grid and my reintroduction to social media, my return to the grid as well. We're also going to be talking about the Flyers' march to the playoffs, and some new plans for my YouTube channel and my YouTube content. Let's start with my brief hiatus from the grid and my return to the grid. It all started around February, like maybe the last week of February. I forget, it was weeks before that, I encountered some issues with my computer. My computer started to slow down. My computer became very slow. We were thinking about getting a new computer. And then all these thoughts went through my head. How am I going to do all my content? How am I going to go on social media? And then I decided to update the windows. I decided to update to Windows 11. Really, you don't know, I use a special computer called the iGaze. And the iGaze version I had did not work on Windows 11. It did not work on Windows 11. It did not work on Windows 11, and When I updated the Windows 11, I called the company. And he said that the hiatus doesn't work when you update to Windows 11. He then told me I should get a new hiatus called the PCI. So, a couple of weeks later, made the decision to get rid of the old computer. And we called the company. They told us we had to get a PCI. So my mom had to order the PCI and also get the new computer at Best Buy. And we got the new computer. It wasn't put together yet. Waiting for the new iGaze to come. And we got it. But then we needed to order a computer stand for the iGaze tablet. It's actually a tablet. But the way it looks, the way it's set up, it kind of looks like a computer. So we got the new computer stand, a new computer. Before we got the new computer, I sent over some of my old files from the other computer through the Google Drive. So I did all that, and then I waited. And then on Sunday, a couple of Sundays ago, I got the new computer put together, tried out the new iGaze, and I got it. And I officially made my return. Yeah. I made my return back to the grid. And I went on Twitter, and I told everybody that I'm back. On Tuesday, It was on a Monday I got the iGaze to work. The new iGaze that I was using. Tuesday, I got back on my computer, did my thing, talked to everyone on Twitter. And things went pretty well. After that, I got officially back on the grid, and I felt happy again. See, I lost my opportunity to go back on the computer for a little while. But I was able to get it back. And I feel great that I can come on here and do this podcast episode and talk to each and every one of you. It feels great to be back. In 2017, I didn't have all this. I lost all of this in 2017 when I went to the hospital, when I was sent to the emergency room, and my whole life changed. But I fought to get that back. And I had to fight to get that back once again, and I did it. I did it. Now moving on, let's talk about the Flyers march to the playoffs. For those of you who don't know, if we don't make the playoffs, if we do make the playoffs, it'll be 3 years since we've seen playoff hockey. Since the pandemic, it'll be 3 years since we've seen hockey, since we've seen real playoff hockey. 2020, the playoff hockey, to me, didn't feel real. It didn't have any substance to it. It didn't feel real at all. It had no substance to it. It had no substance to it, but if they do make the playoffs, if they do, if they do make the playoffs. It'll be a great moment for this city and a great moment for the Flyers fans that had suffered for the past 3 years. To me, it's going to be a wonderful thing to see Flyers playoff hockey back in Philly again. In front of real fans. In front of fans. In front of people. In front of people. And it's a beautiful thing. But before that happens, the Flyers have a lot of work that they have to do to make the playoffs. Right now, the Flyers are sitting in third place. Alexa, what is the Flyers' record this season? Alexa, what is the Flyers' record this season?
This season, the Philadelphia Flyers have a record of 32 wins, 23 losses, and 8 overtime losses. They are in third place in the Metropolitan Division with 72 points.
Flyers, right now, are in third place with 72 points. The Devils, Capitals, the Devils and Capitals, right now, are chasing the Philadelphia Flyers in this march of the playoffs. The Flyers can keep winning games. They can distance themselves from those teams. On Sunday, the Arizona Coyotes beat the Capitals 5-2. And the LA Kings beat the Devils 4-1. Also, the Islanders are in the wild card spot. They're making an attempt to make the playoffs as well. To tell you the truth, I would love to see a Flyers-Islanders rematch. Because we have some unfinished business from 2020. And I have so much respect for the New York Islanders. And so much respect for YouTuber Isles Girl 3. But to tell you the truth, I want this. To tell you the truth, I want that rematch. Because we have to prove to ourselves that we can win. It's been a while since we played in the playoffs against the Islanders. Last time we played the Islanders, it was in 2020, and I'm itching for a rematch with the New York Islanders. I don't know if it's going to happen, but I hope it does. So Islanders, you give me your best. Isles Girl 3, you give me your best. And it's going to be one hell of a series between two teams. Two teams. With heart and determination. I am ready for whatever. The March of the playoffs is going to be a tough one. The month of March is a long haul for the Philadelphia Flyers. But I believe that this team can make the playoffs. I believe that they will make the playoffs. And I believe that I will be fired up and ready to go, baby. Because I'm ready for playoff hockey if it happens. So Flyers, keep doing what you're doing. Keep getting points. Keep winning. Keep doing whatever you have to do to make the playoffs. Because Philly is ready, and Philly is tired of the playoff drought. It's time to put an end to this playoff drought. It's time to get back where we belong. It's time for Flyers hockey And it's time for Flyers hockey to excel in the Flyers playoff hockey. Moving on, got some YouTube updates for my channel. This might be the last time you will see the intro for the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. But don't worry, I will have a new intro coming soon. So stay tuned for the new intro of the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. Also, I will be working on a new intro for Classic Flyers Theater as well. So I suggest you get ready because that will be coming soon as well. And I'll also be working on maybe a new intro for Back in the Day, maybe just a new song. So stay tuned for that. Folks, thank you for joining me here on the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. I'm going to start something very new here, and I'm going to do some podcast suggestions here on the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. So here are my top 10 podcasts that you should check out. At number 10, the Jim Cornette Experience. Number 9, Jim Cornette's Drive-Thru. Number 8, At number 9, What Happens When? At number 7, Something to Wrestle With, Bruce Pritchard. At number 6, The Superhuman Samurai Cyberpod. At number 5, 83 Weeks, Eric Bischoff. At number four, Foley is Pod. At number three, Generation S. At number two, the Icono Classic Wrestling Podcast. And at number one, Isles Girl. At number one, Kim in the Crease. So check out those podcasts that I suggested you check out. They are great podcasts, and they are great listens as well, so check them out. If you have an Alexa or Echo Dot, then you can get Generation S, What Happens When, Jim Cornette Experience, Jim Cornette Drive-Thru, Superhuman, Samurai, Cyberpod, Something to Wrestle With, Bruce Pritchard, 83 Weeks with Eric Bischoff, Generation S. You can all find those on YouTube and on your Echo Dot device. You can find Kim and the Crease officially on YouTube, and the Iconoclastic Wrestling Podcast is also a YouTube exclusive podcast as well. So thank you guys for joining me here on the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. Have a great day, everyone. And let's go Flyers.
So tired of all the darkness in our lives.